Hey, what's happening, YouTube? I hope you're having a fantastic day. I want to thank all my new subscribers. I have quite a few that just appeared out of nowhere, so thank you so much for joining. Today I'm going to do something a little different that I haven't done before. I am going to talk about my five easiest plants to grow from PetSmart. Okay, so I'm speaking to all you beginners or even experts who only have access to a large chain store, being PetSmart or Petco. I'll do Petco another day. But today we're going to talk about PetSmart. And so there are a few things that I took into consideration as to what makes these easy. One is water condition. The plants that I'm going to give you can survive in the crappiest of crap water. Like if you have water that's going through a softener, these plants can handle all that sodium that you've got, because you're going to have about 200 to 300 parts per million TDS of just sodium alone. They can survive that. They can survive if you have really hard water. They can survive those conditions too, or just crud water in general, and you're not ready for all of this, getting an RO unit and remineralizing and everything else. You just want to grow some plants in your crappy tap water. So it's based off that. I also took into consideration lighting, because a lot of people make mistakes when it comes to light. They don't understand what low light means. They don't understand what high light means. You think that it kind of speaks for itself, but it really doesn't when you're talking about low light, just how low it really needs to be or how light. All these plants can survive low, medium, high light. It doesn't matter. They will do their thing. The last thing that I took into consideration is how quickly they grow and how much melt back you get. Okay, so you're going to hear some plants on here that you're not going to hear from other aquascapers when you're looking up five easy plants, because the plants that they're talking about are plants that come from environments where everything is perfect. You know, you order something from Aquarium Co-op, they're not going to tell you that their TDS runs at 50 when your tap water is going to be even, you know, your average tap water could be 50 to 150 if it runs through a softener 2 to 300. So they're not in any particular order, but these are my five bulletproof plants that even in the worst conditions, it doesn't matter the lighting. The only thing that matters is the substrate, and I'll talk about that last. So in no particular order, let's get right into it. Let's go with the foreground plants. So what you would put up front, cardinals, green cardinals. So those you'll see, those will be tissue cultured. They'll be in... Well, I thought I had a bag laying around. It doesn't matter. Anyway, those will be tissue cultured in the little triangular bags. Those will always be at PetSmart. They're called cardinals or green. Those are a good carpeting plant, and I have grown those in the worst conditions. Because remember, I started off as an aquascaper using cruddy water without even realizing it, being successful, and learning about my tap water along the way. All right, so cardinals are great. They like any kind of light. They will grow regardless of what you've got going on. They also don't need liquid fertilizers. I think I forgot to mention that too. All of these plants I'm going to mention, none of them are going to need liquid fertilizers. Okay, so cardinals being number one, that's a foreground plant. Number two foreground plant, repens. Man, repens, they are relentless. I mean, seriously, they can survive the hardest, cruddiest water you can imagine. I couldn't believe when I had started learning about TDS how one tank, everything died, but I just had a sea of repens growing. And when I finally tested, I mean, even fish were dying, but yet repens were just flourishing in crud. Okay, so repens being number two, those will also be tissue cultured in agar. So both those plants foreground in agar. And let's see, number three. Now, the third one on my list, this is several plants, but they're all in the same family, are going to be your Amazon swords. So Amazon sword, Amazon compact, Amazon rosettes. I do want to remind you, though, that if you get an Amazon sword, they get massive. Even in a 40-gallon tank, the Amazon compacts, which are supposed to be small, are going to take up like a foot of space. And the ones that say tall Amazon, that's going to take over everything. I mean, they are huge. So keep that in mind. You plant one of those, they're going to grow quick. It's going to take over everything super fast. So, but they are easy to grow. So all three of those. And then number four being, it's a stem plant. Now at PetSmart, they call them temple plants, which that is a name for them, but their scientific name is hydrophilia. Those you'll find in the tubes. The Amazon swords you'll also find in the tubes also. Those are a stem plant, and those are relentless too. They grow and duplicate like crazy. I mean, within a couple of weeks, you can start propagating them and have them all over your tank. And then the one that I saved for last is also a tissue cultured plant, but it is by far my favorite and really easy to take care of besides what you're going to hear on the internet about it. And that's red undulatas, which common name is red crips, but at PetSmart they're going to be called red undulatas. Now, the reason I chose all of these, you know, I already described, but when it comes to tissue cultured cryptocorns, their whole melting process is much different than ordering it from like Aquarium Co-op or Dustin's fish tanks or, you know, those places. They've already been grown completely submerged and under perfect water conditions, where all the plants you get at PetSmart, none of them have been exposed to any kind of water of any kind, period. And those tubes, they're loaded with agar, and then there's the humidity is just really high, and then the tissue cultures that are just agar, they've only been living in agar. So you kind of have an advantage there because they've never experienced water. Their first time that they spend in water is going to be your crappy water. Okay, so they will learn quickly. They're like, all right, well, this is the dump water I get, so this is what I'm going to live in. And red undulatas, I buy them a bunch, especially from PetSmart, even though they're available, you know, pretty much anywhere. The ones that are tissue cultured, they don't melt nearly as bad as buying the ones that are mature that came from another place where they came from perfect water conditions. You'll lose a few leaves, but they'll stay stagnant and they don't get that big. So you have a 10-gallon tank, and if you want to do a carpet of red undulatas, buy three packs of them, you'll get at least nine. And within 2 to 3 months, you'll just have a whole blanket of this grassy, crips that look great. And I have them in all of my tanks. I prefer buying those than ordering the giant crips that you would get from, you know, ordering online or going to your local fish store, wherever you go. And whenever you're looking up online or YouTube, YouTubing five easiest plants, everyone is going to tell you, one of the most common, it's always going to be like Java ferns and Anubias. Those are not the two easiest, okay? I don't know why people always seem to think that those are the two easiest. For me, those are the biggest pain in the butt for several reasons. One, Java fern, they do melt, and they take months to melt. And while they're melting, they reproduce by growing a baby off of the leaf. So while it's melting, you're waiting for it to grow that baby. Then you got to pluck the leaf that's dying off, then take the baby that's growing on there, pluck that off, and then replant that to where the old one was. And this whole process, you could spend up to 6 months dealing with the whole melting process of Java ferns, not to mention the mess of roots you get with these. It doesn't matter where you get them. I mean, from a big chain store or anyone, you always get this nasty, huge mess of roots that can take you an hour to untangle. And if you don't untangle them, they're gonna die. They are not bulletproof plants. They need a lot of treatment before you plant them. And then they need months of upkeep to keep them going. Okay, so the plants that I gave you, you plant them, make sure there's water in the tank, and some light. I don't care what kind of light. I've had some thrive off of a 40-watt light bulb in my basement, okay, before I started switching to LED plant lights, you know, full-spectrum lights. All right, so whenever you're digging through and someone's keeps telling you, hey, dwarf chain sword and dwarf Sagittarian, Vallisneria, they're all the easy go-to plants. They're easy go-to plants if you have perfect water that doesn't run through a softener. Okay? These people that are telling you that, they didn't start off like you and I, who didn't know anything about our water and are probably using softeners, because a lot of the United States uses softeners. It's just the way of things. Okay, so, but, you know, but if you don't want to deal with learning how to make perfect water, these plants are surefire going to survive. And one last thing, substrate. Do not waste your money on fluvial stratum. Do not waste your money on aquion soil or ADA soil. All of this stuff is going to cost you hundreds of dollars to fill your tank. Use organic soil and black blasting sand. Okay, 1 to 1.5 inch of the organic soil costs you $7 for a bag. And then 1 to 1.5 inch of the black blasting sand, which will cost you $8. It's under $20 and you'll get nearly 100 pounds of this stuff. All right? And trust me, I know. I started off thinking I needed to buy 40 pounds of fluvial stratum and spend $200 on it. No, you don't. Don't be scared of dirt. It is fine. Go buy your organic soil, mix it with a little bit of water, put it on the bottom, and then put your blasting sand on top. Fill it with water all the way, and it'll be easy to plant in. Much easier to plant in than any kind of aquarium soil. Okay? So again, cardinals, repens, red undulatas, any Amazon, and then the only stem I will mention, your temple plants. Those are my bulletproof plants from PetSmart, okay? Start with those. Use your crappy water. You'll have success, I promise. And when you're ready to start digging into plants that require a little bit more maintenance and better water and all of that stuff, I'm starting to cover those plants too. But for all of you that are starting, buy those plants. Say no to Java Fern. Say no to Anubias. They take months and months and months to grow for one thing and to melt and all of that stuff. The plants I give you grow quickly. They don't care about the water. They don't care about the light. All right? So, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic day. And if you're having a terrible day, well, you need to do something about it. Or at least maybe I hope I cheered you up a little bit. But if I didn't, you need to do something about it. Seriously, don't sit there on YouTube all day just, you know, watching videos. I used to do that too. Don't do that. Don't watch movies all day either. That does nothing. It's a waste. Don't waste your life on the couch. Get a hobby. All right. That's it. Have a great day.